Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week?
Arr, X marks the spot. Now I just need me chart to find it. Ahoy there, matey. There she be.
This week, the Lunar X will be visible to Western Europe and the Americas. This unique optical illusion occurs when sunlight grazes across the upper rims of the craters Purbach, Lacaille, and Blancanus. It isn't difficult to find either, it just takes looking at the right time, which this week will be on April 18th. Invisible at 2100 hours UTC, it will pop into view an hour later. Though it really is nicely lit on the peaks with the black shadow below by about 2300 hours. This will still be in daylight for the US though at 7 p.m. EDT, 6 p.m. CDT, but no matter, as you can see, the X can still be seen even in daylight. If you can see the moon, check out the X. And it will be visible for another few hours, allowing the X shape to fade into a darker sky, even as its revolution is altered slightly, pulling some of the lower detail into view. Now, it should be best around 0 hour UTC, which is 7 p.m. EDT, 6 p.m. CDT, but X marks the spot will remain in view for another hour or two after that. Any small telescope will reveal it to you. Use about 100 times magnification. And now this week's dark sky fact. A sunset glow has redshifted light. This helps your body recognize nighttime coming. But computer screens have blue-shifted light, so download the free program Flux to automatically change your computer screen every day to red-shifted light when the light outside does, at sunset. On April 16th, 41 years ago, a Saturn V rocket launched Apollo 16 towards the moon, and 4 days later, John Young and Charles Duke became the 9th and 10th men to set foot on the moon's surface. Visually from Earth, their landing site is not too far visually from the Lunar X, even though the actual distance is some 400 miles away. To find where they landed, look first for Sinus Aspiratatis between Mare Tranquillitatis and Mare Nectaris on the eastern portion of the moon. Early in the week on the 16th, the 100-kilometer crater Theophilus is deeply shadowed, with 53-kilometer Beaumont below it to the south. A day later, two companion craters, Cyrillus and Caterina, are nicely lit south of there. And now we can look for the Apollo site too. From Theophilus, scan west. You'll see the Lunar S created by Mons Penck and the crater Kant, named after German philosopher Immanuel Kant. See the S laying on its side? Just to the west of that is the crater Descartes, named after the Frenchman philosopher René Descartes. Just north of there is a plain, and the Apollo landing site is approximately the same distance from Descartes' northern wall as the crater is in diameter. So just double the distance, and that's right about where Young and Duke were 41 years ago this week. Given the philosopher craters in the area, perhaps that, and when humans may return there, are good things to think about as you observe this area. And now an observing tip. No neutral density filter? No problem! Reduce the moon's comparative brilliance at the eyepiece by setting up near some outdoor lighting, which will keep your eyes from dark adapting and avoiding them hurting while doing lunar observations. Be sure to observe Jupiter in the west this week from 1 to 2 hours after sunset as it drops below 20 degrees of elevation after that time. But spin your scope east to locate Saturn 20 degrees up less than an hour later, over in the east southeastern sky. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller wishing you clear and dark skies.